Thank you for visiting our channel. Today I came out to review and also quick unbox this beautiful remote. It is done by a company called Sofabaton, and the model on this is U1. I have to mention that I got this as a prototype. They are going to release this very shortly on Amazon and other platforms, but for the meantime, it is not released yet. It's a beautiful remote, by the way, and let's go ahead and unbox it. This box is really nicely designed, doesn't have any markings in the back, but once we cut the plastic and open it, you can see the components that are part of this is just the remote and a little user manual. So the remote itself looks very, very beautiful. It is nicely done in the front, looks like a little bit of a glass and a plastic in the back, but it is very rich. So on the top you have a little screen, and then you do have a little roller so you can select your device once you connect more than one device. And then on top of that you have a power for the TV itself. Then going down you have a power button, also escape button. Then you do have a menu, home, and also information button. Then on the left hand side you have the volume up and down, and on the right hand side you have the page up and down, and in the middle you have your navigation keys just like a regular remote, and the OK button in the middle. Going on the bottom part of it, you have a mute button, also a return button or escape button. Underneath of that, you do have the, from the left-hand side, rewind button, or you can go back a chapter. Underneath of it, you have a record button. Then in the middle, you have the play and pause. And then on the right-hand side, you have the fast forward and the stop right underneath of it. Going on the bottom part of it, you have four colors. This, we're going to be able to customize it, like if you have an Android box, you can set it up. And you have the numeric button in the bottom. And also there is two buttons. One is a minus sign beside the zero in the bottom, and also the E button. Those are the ones that we're going to be able to pair this with your app, and we'll get that in a few seconds. It has their name really nicely written in the bottom. And then when you flip it in the back, it has a section that you can put two AA batteries, which is part of the box, and also it is a little bit hard to take out, but there's a catch to it. If you don't put that on the remote, the battery comes out really quick, so it's good to have that on. On the top part of the remote is the IR sensor. All right, so let's go back through it. So in order to pair it, make sure that your Bluetooth is on your phone, and then you have to download the Sofabaton app, which is available on Google Play Store. Once you get that done, then you can open it. And once you open it, make sure you pair your remote for very first time with the app itself. Now, if you have the battery in this for a little bit longer than what expected, it will not going to be able to pair. So you have to take the battery out, wait a couple of seconds, put it back in, what it's asking for, and the app itself, and then it will be able to pair very quickly. Then you have a little plus sign on the top, so you will be able to select your device. So you can see that I have a Psyche monitor that I want to be able to connect to. So you have to go through the list. The list is very big for the TVs itself, and you can go through it to find it. And while you're finding it, I want to mention that this is also compatible to Roku, to Fire TV, and also there is more devices that you can connect this to. And while going through it for the Android boxes, I found a lot of names, but very small does not exist. So if you got stuck, don't worry, message us. We will be able to educate you which device is going to work. And once you find your device, you click on it, then it gives you four steps. So the first step will be to make sure that your TV is off, in this case, and also make sure that you're pointing the remote to the TV itself. You got to go to step number two, and towards the step number three, it will ask you to choose and press the power. So it uses a different code and the remote itself, like a universal remote, in order for you to use your IR sensor to turn on and turn off your monitor. So in this case, I found which was my number two, and then I said yes, and it saved it as a Psyche TV, which is going to show up on my remote, as you can see, or turn off the monitor very easily. So now you can do the same thing with your Fire TV if you have. If you have Sony TV, LG, doesn't matter, if even if it is a smart TV, you will be able to connect to it. This device, it has more ups than down, but again, this is on one of my favorite lists, and I am using it daily for last few weeks, and that's why I thought I should make a video about it. Once this is going on sale, I will be changing some information underneath of this video, and also I'm going to bring some information on our website, which is exitex.info, so you can get some discounts if it's available, also when it's going to be going on sale. I hope you guys like our video. If you do like it, click the like button, subscribe button on the top, comment on the bottom. Always remember to visit our own website, which is exitex.info. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and other social networking places, and thank you.